you're doing things that are that link directly into what we're teaching, which is the creation of a food web.
Food web, yes, absolutely. Right. So, and that was one of the topics I actually had written down was the food web, because I feel like when we talk and people get excited about the food web, the most exciting or the big point to them is the fact that it feeds your fish. So that's their whole motivation. But really, that's kind of almost the side effect or the result because of its existence. The real role of this big group of organisms, mostly microscopic, the biggest role is breaking down those dead, decaying organic material, returning it back into a material that plants and other smaller organisms can bring back up. So as something dies, whether it's a leaf litter, snail, fish, whatever it is, if you have that big army of a diverse group of microfauna and macrofauna, it's going to start attacking it, breaking it down quicker. It basically is going through multiple digestive tracts, and it gets smaller and smaller and smaller until the nutrients are so broken down, plants can directly uptake them with relationship to other things. Those roots are in relationship with fungus and bacteria, and all of it, it's a holistic system. All of it together is what returns a leaf or a dead fish back to Earth. And due to the fact that all these organisms exist, that feeds the fish as well.
Right. So, and that's the difficulty with things like treating your tank with any kind of antiseptic or toxin. Most medications are by their nature toxic. They function by killing something. The goal is for it to be sufficiently targeted to kill only certain things, but there are always guests in the house that get wiped out in the process. It's more like a bomb than it is a bullet. Yep. When you put a chemical in a tank, you're really setting off a bomb.
Right. And you don't really know the relationships you're destroying. I feel like the fish are really part of the food web as well. So the fish are kind of the first level. If they're eating the fish food, their waste is a more broken down version of that food. If a scud were to eat that piece of food, the fish waste is a little more available nutrition-wise to them. If an animal, side note, if the animal is producing waste, it's really only waste to it. So when something poops, basically, we call it waste. It's waste to that animal, but it's still full of nutrients and material that other animals, it's more like a treasure or a food source for other, especially when you get into the microscopic animals. So now
that's what the web means.
Exactly. It's all intrinsically connected. It's very much like a superorganism. This idea that, you know, we have all these separate things living together implies that they are separate, but really they're not separatable, if that's a word. You cannot remove them from each other and have long-term success. So, you know, when they say, and that expands far beyond the barrel or your glass box, it is all of life is that way. It's important to change your mind of what dirt is and what waste is and what, you know, what is soil, this soil that's in the bottom of our aquarium or soil in general outside is death. It is literally all the decayed, broken down, once living organisms, whether that's plant or animal, and soil is death. And where does life come from? From the soil. Where do you put a seed? You put it into the ground, you put it into darkness, you put it into death, and out comes life. So it's that holistic whole, you know, that's the whole point, and that's the connected part, is it, if you want a whole balanced system, you have to have all aspects of it. You can't pick and choose what you want and act like all those millions or billions of years of coming to this point didn't matter. I mean, the fish come out of that system. They are part of the system. They're just as much part of it. And the little creatures need the fish as much as the fish need the little creatures.
Right.
And that's not to say there are not issues in nature. There may be a parasite or bacteria move into a natural system in the wild and wipe out a whole species of fish. That does happen. It's
more commonly, it's not that some foreign bacteria moves into a new environment. The reality is these bacteria have been around for a billion years.
Right. They're already there.
The difficulty is not something new moving in. Yeah. The difficulty is something that is already there being destroyed and creating an imbalance that allows other things to take over and dominate. That's what happens in a fish tank.
I love that,
In a fish tank, because you're using toxins, because you're killing things, as a matter of course, you're creating an environment in which extraordinary life forms can become dominant. All of these exotic diseases that we experience in our fish tank do not exist in nature as significant issues. They exist in what I refer to as the toilet discipline of fish keeping, which is to say you're scrubbing, you're flushing, and you're sterilizing to keep it so-called clean. Hole in head, for example. Hole in head is never seen in nature. It doesn't exist. It exists only in foul fish tanks that have had so many toxins put in them that they have killed off all of the competition for the few exotic bacteria that are able to attack that fish at its lateral line.
Right. I think in the modern world, with technology and lights on and off, we have this day-night cycle, but really there are greater rhythms of life in spring, summer, fall, winter, and you can get in those rhythms, but also your aquarium's already in that rhythm. Like my tanks, for example, in the summer, it might be 78 to 80 degrees in the room. The system usually around 78, or at least last summer, it typically was balancing around 78. In the winter, it got down to as low as 72 at times. So that drastically changed the behavior of the fish, changed the behavior of the plants, growth of the plants. So instead of trying to force those cycles not to exist, okay, well, we're pumping out this many babies a month and we're going to feed this. Just let nature do its cycle, let it do its cycle. And then you'll see, okay, now, wow, man, the last couple months we've been ramping up into spring and now we're going to be going into summer and I'm not perpetuating it. It's already in motion. This is already happening. We're observing it. We're labeling it. We're categorizing it, calling it science. But it's already doing it. We're not making it happen. It's already going.
When I say stop feeding your fish.
Right.
I'm not saying stop putting nutrition in your tank. I'm saying stop using prepared foods as a way of maintaining the balance of life in your aquarium. Putting leaves in your tank, that's nutrition.
It's food, yeah.
That is food, that's nutrients. So I'm by no means suggesting that you should not put nutrients in your tank. You absolutely must put nutrients in your tank. They should be natural. Mm-hmm. They should be either living organisms, they should be organic material that can be broken down naturally like leaves.
A dead plant in your tank, if you leave it in there, it is now a food source.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Those people who find themselves maintaining a tank based on test tubes and test strips always wind up in trouble.
And high anxiety and stress. And,
yeah, exactly. Well, that's right.
Yeah.
That's exactly right.
It's not going how they know it's supposed to go.
Right.
Because they think
they're depending on two or three or four very specific conditions out of the hundreds, if not thousands, of conditions,
right,
all of which are of equal weight in the balance and health of that system.
Right.
A fish tank is the salvation of our way of life.
Yeah.
Because it brings us in personal contact with the natural world.
Yes.
In spite of any effort to keep pulling water out, keep scrubbing it clean, keep throwing chemicals
in, right,
eventually
it keeps going.
Eventually you get tired of killing everything and you ignore it and it starts coming to life.
Right.
And then you look at it and you wonder, how did that happen?
Yeah.
And begin to understand nature is dominant.
Yep.
It is all that is dominant.
Yep.
And we do not control it. We may influence it in some relatively minor ways, but we do not control it. It controls us.
Yeah. If anyone's interested, PhillipsFishWorks.com, PhillipsFishWorks.com. PhillipsFishWorks.com.
And that's your YouTube channel?
YouTube channel, same thing, Phillips Fish Works.
Well, thank you again, Tony. Delighted to have you.
Thank you.
Scintillating conversation.
Absolutely. Hey, anytime.
Everybody's enjoyed it.
Absolutely.